The year of 2024 was definitely one to remember in terms of volcanoes, sadly with a high degree of destruction caused by two particular eruptions. We got to all witness a double Plinian eruption which completely wiped out entire island structures, a series of six more effusive eruptions of Iceland's Reykjanes volcano, and an unexpectedly powerful natural explosion unrelated to human activity at Wyoming's Yellowstone volcano, which was directly witnessed by dozens of people. Across the planet, large volumes of lava were emplaced, significant areas were completely incinerated by pyroclastic flows, and a well-known volcano in Italy gained 151 feet in height. And these are only a select few of the many top news stories that the world tuned into due to volcanic unrest and volcanic eruptions this year. In fact, throughout the entirety of 2024, a total of 71 distinct volcanoes produced eruptions across 28 different countries. The three nations with the most distinct volcanoes that erupted were Indonesia with 15, Japan with 6, and Russia with 4. Across all of these eruptions, an area of 114.85 square kilometers or 44.34 square miles were incinerated for differing reasons. Of this prior figure, 63.35 square kilometers or 24.46 square miles of land were incinerated via superheated gas currents known as pyroclastic flows, with the eruptions of Lewotobi in Indonesia, Ruang in Indonesia, and Kanlaon in the Philippines destroying the largest three swaths of ground. On to lava flows. Lava flows this year covered 51.5 square kilometers or 19.88 square miles of land. The three volcanoes which cover the largest areas of this combined total are the Reykjanes volcano in Iceland, Fernandina in Ecuador's Galapagos Islands, and Kilauea in Hawaii. While those three volcanoes produce the largest effusive eruptions, the largest explosive eruptions of the year originated from Ruang, Lewotobi, and Shivalik respectively. The three tallest eruption plumes this year all originated from the same volcano, Ruang. While Ruang had produced an explosive VEI-4 eruption in 2002 and a volcanic landslide that had produced a deadly tsunami in 1871, its hazards have been greatly underestimated. As, on April 16th, thousands of volcanic earthquakes struck one after the other, leading eventually to continuous harmonic tremor which grew larger and larger. Eventually, magma burst through the plug that had formed, resulting in a sustained Plinian eruption column that lit up the night sky, causing significant amounts of ash to rain down and incinerating all structures on an island formerly home to 1,000 people who had thankfully been evacuated beforehand. An even more powerful Plinian eruption followed on April 30th, creating an 82,000-foot-high eruption column, longer-reaching pyroclastic flows, and causing tens of thousands of pieces of pumice and volcanic tephra to rain down and punch holes clean through metal roofs. Despite the scale of the destruction that occurred, there were thankfully zero deaths, despite the fact that a VEI-5 explosive eruption had occurred so close to tens of thousands of people. As for Lewotobi's eruption, while it was as a whole 20 times smaller than Ruang's eruption, it was deadly in a different manner. At 3 minutes before midnight on November 3rd, building pressure at the Laki Laki cone was violently released. This generated a towering eruption column, but most horrifyingly, ejected thousands if not tens of thousands of golf ball to car-sized fragments of rock high into the air. It would take a sizable amount of time for these boulders and bombs of lava to fall back to the ground, landing as much as 11 kilometers or 6.84 miles from their source. I am sad to say that while many of these thankfully impacted empty fields, some impacted schools, homes, and businesses, causing catastrophic damage and resulting in at least 10 fatalities. One individual stone projectile ejected by the powerful initial blast fell 5 kilometers to the northwest, creating this massive crater where it fell. An additional major explosion followed on November 7th, generating long-reaching pyroclastic flows, only to be followed by a smaller but still large explosion on November 9th. After this, eruptive intensity decreased, but not before creating a viscous basaltic andesite lava flow. in Iceland, this year was the site of 6 volcanic eruptions of the Reykjanes volcano, which all started out with a very high rate of lava effusion, some even approaching 2,000 cubic meters per second before slowly declining in activity. Newly constructed lava berms did their job of protecting key points of infrastructure, causing vast fields of basaltic lava to curve around them. However, a handful of structures, roads, and a large parking lot were covered across these eruptions, two of which even produced very minor ash emissions. Hawaii's Kilauea volcano had a special year, producing a distinct brief eruption in its southwest rift zone, a medium-duration eruption in its east rift zone, and a still-ongoing summit eruption. This is the first time that all three sections of the volcano have each been the site of an eruption since 1974. Moving on to the topic of unexpected eruptions, one volcano produced a far larger than expected eruption, while a second, which was not expected to erupt, produced an explosive eruption without any warning. The former occurred at the Kanlaon volcano in the Philippines, as after multiple months of record-high sulfur dioxide emissions indicating shallow magma was present, it produced an explosive magmatic eruption on June 3rd. It thereafter produced more frequent, weaker ash emissions beginning in October, but on December 9th it produced another large explosive eruption which generated a lengthy pyroclastic flow. As for the unexpected eruption, without any warning on May 24th, Indonesia's Suoh volcano produced a phreatic eruption, sending thousands of tons of rock into the surrounding jungle in a radius of up to 200 meters. Here is some of the best volcano footage of the year, displaying a pyroclastic flow along with an infrared camera view of the same feature generated by the partial collapse of a vent at Italy's Stromboli volcano. And now, here is the current appearance of Mount Etna's Vorigang crater, which had a cinder cone grow on top of it to become the overall volcano's highest point, increasing Etna's summit to an elevation of 3,403 meters or 11,165 feet above sea level. We also were blessed this year with some of the best footage of floating lava balloons you will ever see, courtesy of a shallow submarine eruption of Japan's Iwo Jima volcano. You might have noticed that I utilize multiple clips from the Extreme Pursuit YouTube channel, which I am using with permission. I recommend that you check out his channel via this link or the link in the video description. There, you will find full-length and longer video footage displaying the power and wonders of active volcanoes in Southeast Asia and Oceania, especially the more remote ones such as Ambrim. Thanks to everyone for watching my video content during 2024, and a Happy New Year to you all!